In this blog, we are going to deal with the implementation of file picker in your Flutter application. And the reason for which we are making use of this particular file picker is like we are going to pick up a file and we are going to upload the file to the server. So the file here is like image. Yes, we are going to select an image from our gallery and we are going to upload this particular image to the server. So this is the aim of this particular tutorial, and for which the first thing I want to do is like, I just want to make sure you understand the file picker and its implementation. So here we are making use of an image, but the file picker can be used in various scenarios. For example, you just want to upload an audio file. You can restrict the user from selecting only the audio files from his device. And whenever you want the user to select a documentation like a PDF file or a text file, you can just restrict the user to select only that particular files and push them to the server. So the best example here is like in social media. The best example here I can explain you is like whenever you post a particular image to the social networking sites, there you will be getting a browse button that will be allowing you to choose only images or video files, right? So in the same way, we can restrict our users here itself to select a particular file which is required or which is been allowed to that particular API. And now let's get started with this particular tutorial, and we will be discussing more about the usage and implementation like we go through this particular tutorial. So here the first thing I'm going to add is like file picker here. So I have already added the file picker dependency here, and I have tried to get the dependency to our project. So the reason why I'm choosing a third party tool here is like it is already been thoroughly tested and is been widely used. So if you don't want to make use of a third party tool and you wanted to have the implementation within your application itself, so just let me know in the comment section below. And if majority of the people are looking for their own implementation, I will surely try to make a tutorial on it. And now let's get started with the coding. And the first thing we try to do is like import material.dart here, and then later let's try to start with void main. And let us specify our run app, and inside which we are going to specify my app, that is our default class. Okay, so till now it's well and good. And now basically we try to make use of a stateless widget, but for now I'm just going to make use of a stateful widget. And the reason why I'm making use of a stateful widget is whenever we are going to pick an image, I want that image to be loaded into our application. And with the help of a set state, I can easily do it. So just I'm going to specify stateful widget for that. So this is only the reason why I'm making use of a stateful widget. Instead of returning a container, I'm going to return a material app, and here inside which let us try to specify scaffold here, and within the scaffold now here comes the body section. And within the body section I'd like to have multiple widgets here. So that is why the reason I'm going to specify column, and here row and column are the widgets using which we can specify multiple widgets, right? If you go through our previous tutorials where we have discussed a lot about multi-child widgets and single child widget, all these concepts we have already discussed in our previous tutorials. So I'm just not concentrating more on this particular topic now. Specify children here. So as to specify multiple widgets, we need to specify a children array, and inside which generally when we're trying to specify an image widget, this is how we can specify it. So like image, and whenever you want to specify an image from assets, so this is the way we specify it. So image and asset of image. Okay, and now this time we don't want the image to be loaded from the asset, we want the image to be loaded from the device gallery or wherever the user has saved his image, right? Instead of the local image, I just want to specify an image from file. So image.file, and here you need to specify the file here. And from where do we get this particular file? So before trying to go to the implementation level, let's try to create a global level variable file so that we can get the image from the file picker and store this in this particular file so that we can make use of it later. So by default, I'm just providing an empty here. So empty value for this particular file. And here you can see undefined class file. And from where do we get this particular file? So import.io. So from this particular package, we can make use of the file directory and all these things. So just try to import the .io. And sometimes when you try to tap on import directly here, it will be also importing you .html. So .html, and make sure you only import .io to make use of file or directory and all these kinds of things. If you accidentally try to import .html, then you will be getting an error while implementing it. And the second widget we are going to consider here is like a text button. So whenever you are going to tap on this particular button, the functionality like picking up a file should be implemented. So here for the child, we are going to specify a widget, like a text widget. And here we are going to write a text like pick file, and you can make this constant here. And now let's try to create a method, and the method name also I'm going to specify like pick file. And here you can observe we have followed a camel case notation, and here create method pick file. And this method should be of a type asynchronous. And as we have already added a dependency file picker here, you can just make use of it. So file picker result, you can see we have got all these things from the dependency itself. Result equal to await file picker dot platform dot pick files. And initially I have said you like you can restrict users according to the file type, right? So whenever you go inside this particular method here, you can restrict the user with the help of the type here. So the type of the resource you want to pick from the user device. So here file type dot, we have got an option like image, any, audio, custom, media, all these things, right? So we want an image file. So I'm trying to select an image file. And now let's try to run this particular code and try to check the output once before going any further, whether this particular implementation works or not. So I'm going to run this particular code here, and let's try to see. And here you can see we have got an issue like Android compile SDK version 33, and we are currently using version 32. And you need not worry about this particular error because it's just like a version update. And even with this particular issue, our application works perfectly fine. And here you can see we have got one more error because we have specified an empty value for our file here. And now let's try to see. So yes, we have provided an empty value, right, for file. So just we got this particular error. And now try to tap on pick file here. And here you can see we have got select a photo option here. So have you noticed this particular thing? We have specified file type of image, so we have got that particular folder like select a photo. And when we specify any here, let's try to see what will happen now. Let's try to go back and tap on a picker file. And here you can see when you try to provide any, it is asking you to select any file here. Here you can see we have got image, audio, video, document and all these things, right? So it is asking you to specify the type, and if you specify the type explicitly, then you can pick only that particular extension file. Just try to make use of audio once, and so that you can get a good clarity like how the thing works. And when you tap on pick a file here, here it is showing you only the audio related files. Okay, so currently we don't have any audio related files, so it has brought to this particular page like no items found. And now let's try to restrict ourselves with the image file. and try to make use of it here. So let's go back and tap on pick a file here and select a picture and tap on this particular picture now, and that picture should be loaded into this particular image view, which we need to do now. Okay, let's make use of this particular result here, and before making use of it, let's try to check the result is not equal to null. Okay, and if it is not equal to null, and now let's try to make use of this particular result and try to fetch our image and try to populate it into our image view. So as we are making use of a stateful widget, and also I have said at the initial point of the tutorial, we need to make use of a set state to refresh the view so that the image which we have picked is loaded into our image view. Let's try to store the result into our file, and again here, what is file? File is nothing but our object here which we have declared, right? So that with the help of which we can load our image into the image view. So file of result dot files dot single dot path here. So this is the path of the image which we have just selected, and if suppose there is any error and we have not got the path, then let's try to specify some empty data, or here you can also specify some placeholder kind of thing, so that will be considered and that will be loaded into our image view. Okay, and now let's try to rerun this particular code and go back to the emulator here and try to pick this particular image, and here you can see our image is now loaded into the image view. So that's it. It's that simple here to make use of a file picker in your Flutter application. So the same thing if you try to do in an Android or iOS application level, it might be some more additional task for you, and you have to go through all the permissions and all these particular criteria. But when you make use of this particular third party tool here, it will handle all the things for you. And also I suggest you to make use of this particular third party tool if you are a beginner, because you need not concern about all the granting of permissions or trying to fetch the path yourself and trying to store it somewhere and trying to make use of the particular image path. And all these things will be carried out by this particular third party tool, which is also widely used by a lot of developers, again restricting the user to select any other file rather than the required file. For example, here you required an image file, and if the user try to pick an audio file, then again you need to validate whether the file is accurate or not, and you cannot just upload whatever the file it is being selected, right? So this is why the reason I suggest a third party tool for the beginners. And yes, as I have said earlier, if you want to make use of the implementation within your application, just do let me know in the comment section below. And in the coming tutorial, we are going to pick a file from the user device and try to upload it to the server. So yes, this is it for this particular tutorial. And if you are having any queries, do let me know in the comment section below, and the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. So if you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.